Hello, hello, and hello, everybody.
Welcome back to my Let's Play of Persona 5. Last episode, we did some mementos and other things, and as you can tell, I have a lot of money right now. I did the same trick as before, because, getting money is important. I'll actually be able to showcase that trick for sure later. It's just, usually the trick just takes a while, and I'd rather not bore you guys with that. Alright, anyway, so I believe tomorrow is the fade day for Futaba. Alright. Yep, I got all three of those. Alright, hopefully. Alright. Where is she, Dad? Well, I mean, I maxed out intelligence. I don't need to study anymore. Alright. What's gonna happen? Here we go.
Isn't today our deadline for dealing with Medjed? Futaba's still asleep too. This won't be good.
Hey. There's something I came to do. Today's the day Wakaba passed. I do this every year. Here, I've got a cup for you too. Futaba reminds me so much of her mother. She's a smart girl. Doesn't just go with the flow either. Wakaba, your work and your kid were so fulfilling for you. Why'd you have to die so suddenly? That reminds me. You saw me talking to that prosecutor, and I mean, that woman in the suit, right? I remember you were real bothered by it. She might come back, so I guess I should tell you about it. That woman was trying to get information on Wakaba's research out of me.
That's what we heard in the palace.
You don't need to know what the research was about. Just know there was some trouble around it. Obviously, Wakaba got dragged into that as well. Now, they ruled her death a suicide. But I've got my doubts.
Doubts? Could she have been killed?
Supposedly, there were people who wanted to take her research and use it for their own benefit. Don't get me wrong, though. I don't have a lick of evidence. That's why I haven't told Futaba any of this. I don't want to cause her any more trouble.
It sounded like she had suspicions of her own, based on what she said in the palace.
Still, there's one thing I regret. It was right before Wakaba died. She told me, I think I might die. I brushed it off, thinking it was just a joke. But if I had just taken her seriously... That's another reason I took Futaba in. Redemption. She went through such horrible things. Those heartless adults just yelled at the poor girl. Hey, how do you heal emotional scars?
I don't know, man.
Of course, sorry. Futaba? Huh?
You can't sell this.
Never mind that. But how did you get here?
I walked.
You're okay?
Was that bad?
That's not it. I'm just shocked to see you out of the house.
I'm sorry I worried you.
It's all right.
By the way, what's the date today?
It's the 21st.
I feel like I'm forgetting something. Oh, I remember now. Medjed. Let's take care of it now. Come.
Oh. Here we go.
It's my turn to help out. Medjed. Now how do we cook them?
Eliminate them.
Violent much? Hey, Futaba. We don't have much time left. Are you sure you could do this? The kitty talked? Is this a dream? I'm going back to sleep. It is not a dream! Get up! Say something! Right. Now hurry it up! I guess it doesn't matter. Let's get cracking. You're just tapping away over there. Are you sure this will work? Mm-hmm. Hey, Futaba! I don't think she can hear me. Talk about intense concentration. This place is so messy. I'm surprised she can focus at all. Futaba, you should really clean your room a bit. Huh. She's not listening. Oh well. Just waiting around is boring. Let's clean the place up. Looks a little better now, don't you think? Well, Futaba, we're done on our end. Are you finished yet? She can't hear a word I'm saying. Guess we'll just have to keep waiting. I'm done! What's up? Something happened? It's finished. Finished? What is? It's so clean! Why? We cleaned it. Anyway, is it true? Did you really take care of Medjed? I handled them, and someone else handled my room. I don't understand, but this is good. Futaba? Hey, Futaba, what's wrong? She's sleeping. Well, it looks like it's been taken care of. I guess we should get home and sleep, too.
Hopefully we are in the clear. No. There we go. Oh yeah! I completely forgot I could do that. A nude statue. Alright. Well, Hopefully she does something. Here we go.
Oh, you're finally up, huh? Don't slack off just because you're on summer vacation.
Yo, you look tired.
We've made ourselves at home.
Late last night, it was discovered that someone has tampered with the hacker group Medjid's website. The site's main page now displays what is thought to be the mark belonging to the Phantom Thieves. More so, the personal information of a Japanese man, a possible Medjid member, was illegally publicized.
Aren't these the guys people have been up in arms about?
Medjid has yet to issue an official reply. Furthermore, their previously announced cleanse of Japan has remained unimplemented for now. Some speculate that they have taken this series of events seriously and ultimately canceled their plan.
Yeah. Yes!
What are you all smirking
about? Oh boy.
Well, stop it. You're gonna drive away all my customers.
After the commercial break, we will be asking guests from various fields about this turn of events.
But there ain't any customers.
Can it? My customers are on summer vacation too.
Oh crap, I just realized our break's almost over.
There are still 10 days left.
I wanna go somewhere, but we can't just leave Futaba-chan alone. Something still concerned me too. Like that research.
Oh, did you just get up?
Good morning.
It seems she's cautious of us.
Hey, why don't we go upstairs? If any customers come, she'll be even more afraid.
Why don't you go with them, Futaba? Have fun. It's about time my regulars show up anyway. I don't want you guys loitering around my store.
The fact that there were no damages due to the hacker's actions is but an afterthought. The issue I want to make clear is the attitude of the police, and more importantly, the government. What do you mean? Are they doing their best to find an effective countermeasure against these phantom thieves? Is it not the government's duty to create a society where its citizens can live without worry? Unfortunately, the current cabinet is powerless. As such, they should be disbanded. I believe now is the time for me to risk my political career in hope of making a new reality. A new political system that goes beyond parties or factions. An ideal country of peace and order.
This politician seems quite promising.
I have to agree. I hope he can work to ease the anxieties of the elderly.
What do you think, boss?
Oh, sorry. I wasn't listening.
Oh!
So the Phantom Thieves only stole the heart of Futaba Sakura? And Medjid was in turn defeated by her real-world hacking abilities?
This does correlate to the facts as we know them. If he's telling the truth, then Wakaba Ishiki didn't commit suicide. Did a third party target her life with the goal of destroying her research?
Wakaba's death was 2 years ago. That also coincides with when the incident started occurring. Does this other metaverse user that Madarame and Kaneshiro mentioned really exist? Earlier, I briefly mentioned about those psychotic breakdown incidents that have alarmed the public. All of a sudden, people will lose consciousness or become violent. A situation as incomprehensible as that can't be explained away as troubled social conditions.
I suspect that these cases are all connected to a larger man-made plot. The method involved always muddled the explication, but your story has virtually confirmed its viability. Although I wouldn't have expected a new criminal to come to light from your testimony. What did your group think of this other metaverse user?
The true criminal.
How self-centered of you. The Phantom Thieves tamper with people's hearts without asking consent. How is that different? Well, no matter how you thought of them, there can be no doubting your resolve. Are those incidents because of you or someone else? Either way, I will get to the bottom of this.
Alright. Thank you for your judgment.
Alright.
Now, let's move on to your next crime. Kunikazu Okumura. You should know who he is, considering what happened. Your testimony regarding this incident will be serious. I'm sure you understand why. Answer my next question carefully. What did you do to this Okumura?
To think, the cognitive version of a person would transform into such a horrible monster and attack us. That means our enemies aren't limited to shadows.
I thought the other people were just victims. Like the slaves at the castle, or the walking ATMs.
Even though they seem to be alive, they're only part of the backdrop. The environment, in other words, the palace ruler determines the form and strength of their cognitions. I would have loved to ask Futaba's mother how far along she was with her research.
Research, huh? She was looking into that cognitive science stuff, yeah?
If we put together all the information we've gathered up to this point, abuse of cognitive science can lead to death, and it may even relate to the psychotic breakdown incidents. Considering the cognitive aspect, I sense a strong connection between it and the metaverse.
On top of that, the research might have been stolen and used by someone else.
You mean those guys that showed Futaba-chan the fake suicide note?
If that is the case, those people are unforgivable.
Hey, Futaba. Is there anything else you can remember? She is quite difficult.
That smell.
Come on, no fair!
Hey, can I snag a bite? Meanie.
Why don't we take a short break? I've been thinking, even if Futaba is a genius, could she really crush an international hacker organization that easily?
The one who taunted the Phantom Thieves was a guy in Japan. I knew the Medjed members in Japan weren't anything special, so I wasn't worried. How do you know that? 'Cause I'm the founder.
Oh!
What do you mean? Should we take that literally? Yep. It was only me at first, back when I was referred to as the Hacker of Justice. But since I stayed anonymous, a bunch of guys from all over the world started using the name.
And those were the ones committing cybercrimes.
It was a hassle to expose all of them, so I just left them be.
So... Futaba was the true Medjed, and we were freaking out over some weak-ass dipshits? You should have told us from the start, Futaba.
I discarded the Medjed name a while ago. I'm Alibaba now.
Futaba, what do you want to do now? Since you know our secret, we'd like you to join our team.
Okay? Just like that?
This may even ensure our investigation of the mementos goes along smoothly. Well, I guess.
Well, Futaba's real amazing. She's gonna be a big help for us, huh?
Say, Futaba, how did you find out about us?
Secret.
Where did you learn to hack?
Private.
When did you obtain the nav?
I refuse to answer.
Futaba-chan sure is unique. Still, it'll be a problem if she doesn't open up to us some more.
At the very least, we need to be able to communicate normally with her.
What should we do?
I think she's okay as it is.
That ain't gonna fly.
First, we'll need to help her open up to us. If we each spend an entire day with her, maybe she'll get more used to being around us.
I see. We do have the time, thanks to summer vacation.
We can begin tomorrow.
Let's go to the beach! There'll be tons of people there. Plus, we got totally dried out in that desert.
That's a great idea! I forgot I hadn't gone to the beach yet.
Excuse me. I'll come by tomorrow. See you then.
Let me help as well. I don't have anything planned.
Thanks. We can set a schedule with everyone else depending on when they're free.
Okay! Can I really do this? Why me?
Stress is the enemy of beauty, you know.
How can I stay calm about this?
I understand how you feel.
Thanks to the incident with those hackers, people are calling us incompetent. And on top of all that, the Phantom Thieves are claiming justice is on their side. Don't make me laugh.
Mejed was dealt with by either the Phantom Thieves themselves, or some avid supporter. There are no tracks whatsoever, so they must be quite skilled. Either way, the general public recognizes the Phantom Thieves as the subjugating party.
They're gaining support and influence much faster than we could have anticipated.
It is indeed an abnormal situation. I'm beginning to suspect mass manipulation of some kind. It's even possible that a powerful person is behind them, plotting the psychotic breakdowns. If only I had realized sooner.
It's rare to hear you speak in that tone.
For the sake of my justice, I won't forgive them.
Oh. I can actually have a free day today. Wow. That's actually kind of convenient. Oh, and you have a link too. Unfortunately, I can't do your link for today, so Jiro. I have to do a job. Yeah, let's get to work. Nothing really. Let's talk to Downcast Woman. Well, I mean, kindness is good.
All right.
Our master would like a word with you. Stand up straight and listen closely, inmate.
It seems you freed the heart of a frenzied girl and saved her from her haunted past. Another step has been taken to rehabilitation. You are progressing quite nicely.
Our master bestows words of praise upon you. You'd better feel honored.
By the by, more curious information has found its way to your ears. A scientist's research. It seems that world may secretly be known after all. Furthermore, that very research has been stolen and is now used by those with malicious intent. I wonder how this will change the approach you take toward your rehabilitation. Allow me to grant you a new power worthy of your current self. Though you have my aid, be sure not to let your guard down. Otherwise, you may get swept off your feet.
Oh.
All right.
It's just the main Kaya.
We shall meet again in the near future.
Time to go, inmate.
Oh, there we go. Makoto, will that be enough? All the figures I messed up.
No.
see.
Right, right! Hey.
Oh yeah. I can do that now. I can do Sojiro too.
You got time right now?
Oh no, it's not gonna. Oh,
next time then.
Let's do Fortune then. At least I think it's Fortune. I mean, I could do the shop, but I have a chance to do Fortune.
Way too high.
What do you think? Fine. Her boyfriend stopped abusing her? I don't believe it. But even if he did stop, her fate should still be heading down the path to misery without changing. I mean, look. What? The sequence of Arcana has completely changed. Death has moved far off into the future. No, no, no! This must be some sort of trick. What are you, a scam artist? You made a deal with her boyfriend or something, didn't you? Then what did you do? Did you plunge him into Tokyo Bay? Or cram him into a metal drum and dump insects on him? You must have taken some sort of extreme measures. Well, you certainly do seem like just an ordinary high school kid. But there's no way that could have happened without you breaking the law. I mean, how could an ordinary high school student change the course of fate? Fine. I'm just going to have to verify your power. The very power that reversed my tarot card prediction. This is quite a serious situation for a fortune teller like me. I need to get to the bottom of this. You won't have to do anything. Just sit next to me while I tell fortunes. And if another unopposable fate happens to appear, then I'll test your power. Well, that may be true. Oh, I know. I'll read your fortune. Please? I'll even prioritize your readings over my regular customers. Besides, I'll be able to provide much more accurate predictions once I get to know you better. How does that sound? Is it a deal? Otherwise, I won't be able to go on. Please, I beg you. I need to know if fate truly can be changed. You will? Really? Okay then, I look forward to verifying your skills. Please don't blow me off, okay? We made a deal after all.
Unless you were lucky, there's no way you could have repeatedly done so many crimes. Or perhaps you had someone you consulted who gave you precise advice. You're not getting away this time with just luck.
It shall become the wing with the birth of the fortune.
Yep, fortune. Tempo increases the quartz set of it. Ooh.
All right.
That is actually going to be good.
Is fate really something that can be changed? If it's really possible, then... Oh, it's getting late. Let's close up shop for today. It's past your curfew.
Here we go.
Wow.
What's up? Hey. Come on. Hey.
How suspicious.
Hey!
Okay. I can do star. Well, let's just check Shinjuku really quick. Yeah, she's not there. We'll do crossroads. So I can set up that request for later. Actually, no, I can do Shinjuku any day. Yeah, so I'm gonna do Star instead. I might as well start trying to raise that up a little bit because
hey, inmate.
I really want Star maxed out as well. There's one thing in the future that I want to do that I don't think will be a problem now. All right.
You got to read. These are the paths you have walked.
I don't think I have Neko Shogun. Need a star. Star, where are you? This is star.
A fee is required. Then accept this.
Done already?
Yes.
No slacking off.
All right, let's go to the store. Yeah, it's been a long time since I hanged out with you. And I apologize because I had other confidants that were important. To be fair, I don't know if Sun had a time limit or not. Someone told me this and couldn't risk it. So you know what? That is fine. Unfortunately, I don't think her bonuses are going to help me at all. Because I already have maxed out knowledge. Alright.
I look forward to it. I'll start.
I mean, it's interesting. I mean, don't worry about them.
Yes.
All right, story two.
All right.
Oh.
You don't want to, right? I mean, that knowledge would have been nice if it wasn't maxed out.
All right.
Until next time. Well then.
Here we go. You okay? My God. Take that thing off.
Huh? What?
Uh-huh. Alright, we're gonna call an episode here. So I'll see you guys next time. Till then, see you guys later.